Hey, never unpacking is what new house is for. I bet you everybody has like one box that they never unpacked, or they just chucked everything in a drawer. As we're walking home, I hear heavy footsteps come up behind us. Big Daddy! Bro! Craig? Bro? Bro! Holy! Wow, I haven't seen Craig in forever. Yeah, wow, you look great. You kidding me? He's ripped. Hey, it's not all about looks, Amanda. Amanda, this is my friend Craig. We went to college together. We were roommates for a while, too. Amanda, dude, you probably don't remember me, but you're so big now. Hello? And hello, cute baby. Oh, thank you. Last time I saw you, I think you were about her size. This is River. Say hi, River. Are you babysitting? Nah, dude. River's my kid. Does anyone in chat have kids? I actually don't have any kids and I don't want any kids. So I don't even know if this is really a game for me, because I would probably want a guy that was not a daddy, but you know. How's Smashley doing? I mean, Ashley. Ashley is her name. She actually still goes by Smashley. And we got divorced last year. Aw, dude, I'm so sorry. Wait, if you just. How old's the baby then? If you split up a year ago, how old is this baby? Did you split up, like, before the baby was born? Keg Stand Craig is a father of. Oh, haha, yeah, it's my old college nickname. Got it because he did a lot of keg stands. Yeah, keg's not really a thing here, but that's kinda like a. American high school stereotype. Ah, bro, I hate to be that guy, but I'm in the middle of my daily jog and I really gotta keep my heart rate up. I brought River along for, you know, resistance training. Are you really gonna run with a baby? I jog daily or yearly. On January 1st, when I promise myself that I'm gonna jog daily for the rest of the year, but give up 30 minutes and just walk home. I used to be mad into running when I was younger, and like a cross-country team. But I got a really bad foot injury and I basically had to give up running, and it's still so sad. Like, running is actually really good fun. It only takes about a month to get good at it. But yeah, I broke my foot. It's more like maybe a condition I was born with, but yeah. That's why I end up stuck in so much, because I actually get like quite a lot of pain when I'm even walking, and it's just so annoying. I basically always have this dull pain like in the back of my mind. So yeah, I get really jealous of people that's like super fit on with stuff they can do on their feet. Sorry about your foot. Nah, you don't need to be sorry about it. I'm used to it now. I like to see people that's super athletic and stuff because I'm like, oh, I wish that was me. Yeah, I'll show you what I do instead. Yeah, this is my weight. I just pump the guns. That keeps me fit. You designed Big Daddy? No! Oh, the character, yeah. Yeah, with the love heart eyes. Yeah, our character is the cutest one in this so far. Come on, it'd be fun. We could grab breakfast afterwards, catch up. We could do a bro brunch like the good old days. Mine's is something called Freiberg's disease. It's basically that I was born with like a hairline fracture in my foot. But as I got older, especially like when I went through puberty, like I got more and more pain in my foot because like the way a baby's feet are and the way an adult's feet are kind of different. So my foot doesn't really look like it looks totally normal from the outside, but inside it's got like a crack. It's kind of annoying. But basically, I went to the doctor and they were like, oh no, you've just got a sprain for like literally years. So I ended up not diagnosed until I was like in my 20s. So I can definitely believe when people say they never got diagnosed with something by a doctor. Craig gives a little wave, puts his earbuds back in, and jogs off. I can't believe Craig is ripped and has kids. I'm reeling. Craig, I knew, is not fit to be responsible for any living thing. Including and especially himself. One time I watched him drink an entire jar of marinara sauce for dinner. Okay, Craig is a bit of a weirdo. Is drinking an entire jar of marinara sauce a deal breaker, guys? Is it a red flag? And does Craig have to get scored off the the list? I don't know, drinking a whole jar of sauce is kind of weird. And then he drank it like it was a normal thing that normal people do. It was unholy. And I asked him, what the hell is he doing? And he said, and I quote, it's basically a smoothie, bro. I actually don't even like, you know, Bloody Marys and like Virgin Marys where it's like apple juice. No, what'd you call it? Tomato juice? Oh, that just, even that freaks me out. I mean, technically he's not wrong. He jogs. He was jogging. He's like a totally different person. Anyway, we better get home. I have plenty of time to reflect on how old I feel later. Oh, same. Same. I feel so freaking old sometimes. It's just, you're my little girl. It's gonna be weird not having you around. One of my hamsters is up to nonsense. Your characters make me think of a mix of John Constantine and Corinthian from Sandman. Like, I wrote a funny story where basically Doctor Strange was evil in every other universe, but John Constantine was good in every other universe. And then it was kind of like a versus of like an army of like good universe John Constantines versus evil universe Doctor Stranges. I liked it. I wrote it for myself, basically. Oh, come on. I'll be fine. I'll get a dog or something. Yeah, like, I kind of want to get a cat or a dog, but it's just a lot of work, so I can't be bothered. I'd love a little, like, a Pomeranian or something that's small, like, kind of just a small dog. TJ has a dog for you. What kind of dog? About to do a shocked face, but you know what? Yeah, I do. Yeah, I'd like to see your dog. TJ is dog sitting and is in denial that the dog is his forever. Yeah, I mean, that's how you get a dog, really, isn't it? You look after someone's dog and then you... That's how I got a cat. Like, someone had a baby and they were like, can you take my cat while the baby's tiny? And I was like, okay then, thinking the baby was a bit older, but they just never took the cat back and I ended up with the cat forever. I don't think you'll get rid of it, to be honest. Don knows the truth. Yeah, I mean, that is literally how you get pets. More than 2 years. Yeah, okay, that's just your dog now. You're kind of stuck with it after 6 months. 2 years is definitely your dog. I'm the expert on this, TJ. I've had it happen to me. You're a single female lawyer. Maybe this game can help you find your dream daddy. You don't need to be a single female lawyer, you can also be a dream daddy. You're not a lawyer, I know, Cass. It's the meme, the single female lawyer. That's an old one from the 90s. Single female lawyer is Ally McBeal. Can we go to the union meeting or go clubbing? Come on, guys. What do you think is better for meeting men? Nightclubs or union meetings? I think we'll go union meeting. Bossman's been riding us trolls too hard. It's time to rise up. Dad, you're not even going to invite me to the riot? I'm sorry, sweetie. It's an honest day's work for an honest day's riot. I never even watched Ally McBeal back in the day, but it's just such a famous kind of show. I'm just kidding. I'm actually going to go out and watch the game. No, let's just go back to bed. Theater connections? I go to the theatre sometimes, but mostly just with my mum. Just as I'm heading towards my room, the doorbell rings. Cue obligatory Debussy music. Yeah, I love a bit of Debussy. This is one of the most beautiful songs ever written. I walk over to the door and open it. Hello. A handsome, clean-cut man stands at my door, brandishing a plate of cookies. Well... Hi, I know it's late, but I baked way too many cookies and I just can't have these in the house or I'll eat them all. Oh, where are my manners? Okay, I don't know with this guy. I don't know if any of these, none of these guys are going to be my type. Oh, where are my manners? My name is Joseph. I'm your next door neighbor. Oh yes, hi, I'm Big Daddy. I just like t-shirt jeans guys that sent in like video games and not pure preppy guys. Preppy guy is like my nightmare. Wanna date a guy who's prettier than you are? I doubt that's true, the guy is prettier than you. You're all like super good looking, like all of you. Every one of you is like 10 out of 10. That's Tetris 99 gang is like ridiculously good looking. Amanda pokes her head out of her room and immediately hones in on the cookies. Wow, cookies, huh? Joseph hands her the plate of cookies with a smile. This guy is creeping me out. We do have to actually pick one of these guys. We can't just say no to every single one, but it's looking that way. Is the missus around? No, not anymore. She died. Oh. Why did we say it like that? I'm sorry for your loss. No, it's alright. Yeah, he's just like literally showed up at our house. I'm sorry, can you close the door real quick? Hey, I'm your new neighbor, Joseph. I promise to not talk about your dead spouse this time. I'm throwing a barbecue for the cul-de-sac, and I'd love for you to come by and meet the rest of the neighbors in our community. What'd you say, pal? That sounds great. My daughter Amanda would love to stop by. So, by the way, anytime I play a dating game, I have, like, comically bad luck in it. So, like, when I played Stardew Valley, I ended up with Shane, who was, like, an alcoholic that tried to kill himself. And then when I played, How to Fool Boyfriend, I ended up with the serial killer pigeon. So, yeah, well, I'm actually very skeptical that I'll end up with a nice guy here. I feel like whoever I pick is gonna have, like, some secret evil side to them. So I'm definitely very, like, scared of dating games now. But yeah, How to Fool Boyfriend, he was, like, a crazy serial killer doctor. It wasn't good. It was hilarious, but it was not good. Oh, and then I played another one, and the guy I picked locked me in a cage at the end of the game. I got locked in a freaking cage. What game? Oh, it's called Amnesia. He seemed nice. You're just saying that because he gave you cookies. Amanda walks back into the living room, crumbs on her face, and cookie in hand. He likes little boys. Oh no. Yeah, youth pastor does sound quite sus. No offense to any religious people, but obviously it doesn't have a good stereotype. Right, well, kiddo, I'm gonna catch some Z's. All we have done in this game is sleep so far. Hurry, the Z's are getting away. I run down the hall towards my bedroom. Joseph better not be in my fucking bedroom. Cause, yeah, Joseph's scaring me just like showing up at my house. I'm hot on the trail, I'll get 12 hours of quality sleep if it's the last thing I do. Yeah, more like maybe 6 hours. As I shut the door behind me, Amanda's laugh echoes through the hallway. You love the wall with the original art? Thank you. I like it. Rise and shine, early bird. Still wanna work out? This is Craig, by the way. Smiley face. Holy crap, it's 6 a.m. Who does 6 a.m. anymore? Without realizing it, I drift back to sleep. Hey bud, still wanna get your swole on? I'm ready to tear up the track. Hit me up. You've been keeping really bad hours. Yeah, I don't know, when do you sleep, TJ? Cause you always seem to be like, awake. It suits me, cause I love to see you around. Okay, gem or sleep, guys? Gem, okay, we'll go meet up with Craig then. Hey my man, I need a few minutes to wake up, but let's meet in 20. Who the hell can wake up and meet up with a friend 20 minutes later? I'd never be able to do that. It's good to get all snuggled up in bed. I snuggle up with my little munchlax. Like, the neighborhood is quiet and serene this early morning. Birds chirp and the grass is still wet with dew. Surprisingly, the gym is pretty crowded. I spot Craig standing out front, stretching of course. He spots me and waves enthusiastically. Hey bro, good morning. Hey, good to see you man. I'm definitely not as pumped up as he is. You ready to kick some butt? Hell yeah, let's go Craig, let's pump the iron. Or be careful, I end up putting my shoulder again. Gotta stay positive. Help! This is it, this is how I die. Okay, that'll be alright, dude. We'll ease you into it. We head into the gym, and I'm immediately intimidated. All these people look like they could break me in half. Don't be intimidated by people in the gym, like, nobody pays any attention to other people at the gym. It seems like Craig is friends with all of them. He high-fives and finger guns all the cool jocks in the room. They look like they could and would steal my lunch money to spend on protein shakes. I thought about trying protein shakes, they look kinda good. But then my problem's the opposite, I should lose weight rather than put weight on. Come on, bud. Let's warm up. Okay, I can walk. Walking is good. This is a decent place to be, walking. Finger guns. Hi, TJ. It might be a little scary, but I guarantee that all of them serve a specific purpose for building muscle mass. I watch as a dude in muscle tee flexes a muscle I didn't know existed on a machine I think was once used to process grain and flour. Yeah, that's pretty much my thinking when I'm at the gym. I'm like, that doesn't even look like a gym machine. What is that? What is that guy doing to himself? That's a good question, bro. What do you think he's doing? Okay, what are our options? We've got training to crush people's skulls with his thighs. I feel like I could do that, but I have never tried, so I don't know. That's like when everybody thinks they could fight a bear. I think that I could, yeah, I could maybe do that. Using a medieval torture device? Or praying to some sort of pain god? We have got to go for the crushing skulls. He's trying to make his thighs so strong that he could crush people's skulls with them. Yeah, anyone want to volunteer to see if I could do that? If I kill you though, I would have to apologize beforehand. Yeah, that's pretty much the only reason I work out. Exactly, Craig, exactly. Oh no, Craig is turning up the speed. I better do the same. See, that's the one thing never do in the gym is try to keep up with other people in the gym. Because inevitably some 70-year-old person will come in and be like the best at everything in the gym. It's kind of like a law at the gym that the best people are like in their 60s. Because they're like retired, they've got nothing better to do than go to the gym all day. If you turn the speed up, that is the quickest way to get killed at the gym. How long have you been doing the buff thing? The buff thing? What do you do when you're not dadding or working or buffing? I keep busy. What do you do for fun? He's basically saying his only hobbies are sports. Like, I'm not against sports, but I cannot be dating a guy who's into sports, like, into sports. Since the only sport I watch is pretty much, like, maybe the boxing or the wrestling, but that's about it. So everyone went crazy here recently for football because Scotland was playing. And it's kind of a funny in-joke, I guess, where Scotland always loses, always. But people, like, celebrate, like, so hard, even though they know that. And it's kind of, like, ironic, I guess, or I don't know what you call that when it's, like, sarcastically celebrating millions. I try to live my life as close to a Jimmy Buffet song as possible. I have no idea who Jimmy Buffet is. I check out my hot bod. I mean, let's just check out our hot bod. That's our hobby. I spend most of my time in front of the mirror admiring my Adonis-like figure that I've worked so hard to sculpt. I feel like that line's gonna work on Craig. He's just gonna be like, yeah, me too. By that I mean, lay horizontal and watch bad television. Yeah, that's a bit more accurate. We're jogging now. Oh god, we're jogging now. I look over at Craig, who hasn't even broken a sweat. How is he doing this so effortlessly? I'm dying. Oh, my life force draining through every orifice of my body. Really? Every orifice? Surely not every orifice. That's too disgusting. Margaritaville. Hey, remember when my fish died in college? No, I don't like this story. No, no fish dying stories. I'm too much of a bleeding heart of animals. Oh my god, is he really bumping up the speed again? I guess I better do it too. Oh, this is fast. This is very fast. Yeah, I would be thinking that if it just went off walking pace. And we were at that party and you vowed to make me feel better. You tell me to create a distraction, so of course I do a sick keg stand and everybody's cheering, Craig, Craig, Craig. And then I half tried to steal a fish from the fish tank at the party with my bare hands like an idiot. And then you drop the fish and it's flopping around and you panic. So you run up to me post keg stand with a dying dirty fish in your hands and you scooped off the ground and you're yelling at me that we have to leave. Oh no, I knew this fish was gonna get killed in this story. Why? So we're running out of a frat party and with a fish and trying to give it mouth to mouth resuscitation. And we get him home and get him into a fishbowl and the prognosis was grim. And then the next day, he's alive and well. Oh, phew. This is like a troll story. They never did catch the great fish thieves of Grand Ridge U. And they never, huff, will. I shoot off the end of the treadmill and crash into the wall. Jesus, that hurts. Dude, bro, are you okay? Craig offers me a hand and looks me over for injuries. I'm fantastic. I manage to stand up and rub my back. It doesn't hurt now, but I'm sure it will later. You don't have to push yourself like that. Always know your limits. Well, I think I might call our gym adventure here. Yeah, me after about 2 minutes at the gym. Sure? Yeah, like we literally just got here. Alright, well here, I brought you this. Craig hands me a shaker bottle full of thick green liquid. I stare at it with what must be apparent distaste. That's totally me, like I just get to the gym, work out for about 2 minutes and then I'm like, alright, I'll catch you guys later. I'll meet yous out in the cafe. Definitely the best strategy. It's a protein shake, bro. Oh, thank you. Like, do protein shakes work? Because I heard that you just drink them and you become like mega buff, basically. He wants me to drink it. Oh boy, here goes. Take a small sip. It's actually delicious. Wow, this is really good. And good for you. It's my special recipe and I'm pretty proud of it. Let me know if you ever want to work out again. Maybe we can try running around the neighborhood if treadmills aren't your speed. No pun intended, bro. Good one. Well, I'm gonna go put ice on this, everything. I'll see you around. I leave the gym feeling ashamed. Yeah, that's more accurate. Craig used to order delivery from the pizza place across the street from our dorm. And now he can run circles around me. Literally. Man, I really gotta work on this dad bod. Dad bod? Yeah, what kind of body do you like? Do you like slim, bigger? I get home and lie down on the couch. It hurts to move. Oh god, I'm so old. Ah, true. Even just lying down on the couch can be sore. Okay, we fell asleep again. Like, how many times have we slept in like one day in this game? Oh no, I must have fallen asleep. What time is it? Shoot, it's 3:55. I'm supposed to be at Amanda's school in 5 minutes. I arrive at Amanda's school and check in at the front desk. I'm barely awake and feeling pretty haggard. Wait, was it room 103 or 108? I spot a youth standing at his locker and approach him for help. Excuse me, do you know where Mr. Vega's classroom is? The youth turns around and looks me up and down. Heavily lined eyes. Come on, kid, I'm late for a meeting. Mr. Who? Mr. Vega. I don't know, have you tried the exit? Okay, wise guy, are you gonna help me or not? Fine, up those stairs and to the left, can't miss him. That punk youth sent me on a wild goose chase. I get back to where that low-rent Gerard Way is standing, fully ready to give him a piece of my mind, when suddenly a head pops out of the classroom next to his locker. Listen, don't you have third period to get to? Yeah, so we've got Magnum PI, this is more like it. Sigh. Fine, Mr. Vega. Wow. Now I'm officially 10 minutes late. Okay guys, what's gonna be wrong with this guy? There seems to be something wrong with every guy in this game. Nobody is just a normal guy. I actually used to love the show Magnum PI like so much back in the day. I don't even watch a lot of those kind of crime shows. Yeah, I used to watch Magnum PI. So I still have it on DVD. So don't judge me, but I do love a bit of Tom Selleck. I used to get teased for it back in the day, but in a fun way. So like one of my friends gave me like a Magnum PI fridge magnet. Just because it was so like lame to watch Magnum PI. Never did watch that show. Yeah, probably for the best. The show was like massive in the 80s. But it has one of the funniest, like, yeah, it's so silly. Like, some of the plots were ridiculous in that show. Like, at one point, it turned out the guy was, like, cryogenically frozen. And that made me laugh so freaking much. Like, have you seen this clip?
Guns don't work on Sunday.
Nuns don't work Sunday. If you see a nun working on a Sunday, shoot her. She's definitely evil. Nuns don't work Sunday gets me every time. Yeah, it's such a stupid show. Yeah, he's literally just like, wait a minute, nuns don't work Sundays, and just shoots her. That's why I'm like, he's a better detective than freaking Batman and Sherlock Holmes.